Very good morning to all my dear students. I hope you all are fine and staying safe at your homes. So today I'm going to teach you the topic of first flight, chapter 3, two stories about flying. My dear students, this story has two parts. The part one is his first flight and the second part is the black aeroplane. Today we'll discuss about the first story, his first flight. First let me discuss with you about the author. This story, His First Flight, is written by Liam O'Flaherty. He is an Irish author, a famous short story writer, and an Irish novelist. He was a major figure and still a major figure in the Irish literary front. He also served as the Western Front as a soldier in the Irish Army. He is still considered a great story writer and an Irish novelist, and he has a great place in the Irish literature. So now let me discuss about you about the theme. We all know that we all have some fears, some apprehensions, and we all start some work sometimes for the first time. So this story is also about to overcome your apprehensions, your worries. Sometimes we feel it very difficult when we start any of the new work. But we know that the journey of 1,000 miles always starts with a single step. So the story deals with the same theme. We need to overcome our fears, our apprehensions, and for that, self-reliance and self-motivation are the keys. If you have the determination to do any work, then you can overcome your fears, your apprehensions, and you can excel in that work. So now let's discuss about the story. This story is about a young seagull, a bird who was very young and was afraid to fly away. Even his parents, his younger brother and sisters, they were motivating him to fly, but he was very much afraid, very much afraid stricken that he was not able to do that. So this story is of a young seagull who is afraid of flying. A family of seagulls lived on a ledge. Ledge means on a bank of a sea. A young seagull is left alone as he is afraid to fly and is one among the slow learners. All that this young seagull needed was motivation. By way of punishment, his family left him alone on the ledge and flew away. They scolded him, upbraided him, taunted him for his covered eyes, and even threatened to let him starve. He remained hungry for 24 hours and was unable to shed off his first flight. His parents motivated him, scolded him, upbraided him, and even just left him to be starved on the ledge. They all made him left alone, and they all flew away. But even then, due to his apprehension, due to his fear, the young seagull was unable to fly. He had a fear that if he'll even try to fly, he would fall away and in the vast sea. So he was not able to take his first flight. He cried, begging his mother to bring some food. Even his mother played a prank. She just came to him with a fish in her mouth, but not gave to young seagull. So it just some way motivated young seagull, and he just collected and gathered his courage and tried to fly. She picked up a piece of fish in her beak and flew across him and stood just in front of him. The piece of fish in her beak was almost within the reach of his beak. The young seagull got mad with hunger. He dived at the fish. The next moment he found himself falling outwards and downwards into space. Instinctively, he spread his wings and flapped them. He soared upwards and all his fear is gone. It was a joyous moment for his family. He forgot that he was ever afraid of flying. So my dear students, you have seen that how his own see what happens if we have to do anything. The others can only motivate us, but ultimately we are the doer. We have to put our own efforts, and this is the self-determination, self-motivation, your courage that can help you to overcome your fears and to do any of the tasks. No task is difficult. We know that for every single step we have to put our efforts. Self-reliance is very important. So this story is about overcoming fear in life. Self-belief and confidence can be brought about through self-motivation. Now, I request all of you to take a thorough reading of the story, underline the difficult, the new words, and write down their meanings. And now, I'm going to give you some questions related to this chapter. You have to complete these questions and show it to me as early as possible. I'm just waiting for your answers to post me through the WhatsApp group. So please, I'm requesting you to write down few questions of this chapter. These are only one word or one sentence answer that you have to give. Question number one, the young seagull was alone on his dash. The young seagull was alone on his dash. Question number two, the young seagull was frightened to fly with his brothers and sisters because he was dash of the sea. I repeat, the young seagull was frightened to fly with his brothers and sisters because he was dash of the sea. Next question is, the young seagull was on the ledge because his mother had asked him to remain there. The young seagull was on the ledge because his mother had asked him to remain there. Next question. The young seagull ran back away to the little hole under the dash where he slept at night. I repeat, the young seagull ran away back to the little hole under the sea where he slept at night. Last question is, find the synonym of gather from your chapter. Find the synonym of gather from the chapter. So I'm just waiting for answers. Revert to me as early as possible. If you have any query related to this story, please ask me. You're most welcome. Thank you.